डॉक्टर बाबा साहेब आंबेडकर ओपन यूनिवर्सिटी।
गुड डे फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम इनटू द चैतन्य स्टूडियो ऑफ डॉक्टर बाबा साहेब आंबेडकर ओपन यूनिवर्सिटी। आई डॉक्टर अजय पटेल, वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस रिगार्डिंग द इंट्रोडक्टरी पार्ट ऑफ द साइबर सिक्योरिटी। एंड इन दिस सेशन वी विल डिस्कस रिगार्डिंग द साइबर सिक्योरिटी, what is the cyber security, and we will also discuss regarding the cyberspace as well as some encryption technology. Okay friend, so first of all, before we discuss what is the cyber security, let's start with some negative statement. Negative in the sense, first of all, we need to understand what is not a cyber security, because regarding cyber security there are lots of misconception in society. Everyone is watching movies, and in movie this kind of the you can see the images like someone is accessing the terminal and from the command line or from the message like file is being transferred, and then after mission incomplete or the your system has been hacked, etc., etc. So all these kind of hacking are only possible into the movies only. Actually, cyber security has lots of domain, various domains, various subdomains are in cyber security, like we can say web application security, mobile application security, network security, cloud security, mobile, etc., etc. So hacking is not only to use some tool or to apply some we can say some novice technique, or we can say some error message, or to generate some error into another computer is not a hacking. But what is the cyber security? So cyber security, that means if we try to define the cyber security is a technology. Again, it's a framework and practice designed to protect networks, devices, programs and data from attack, damage or unauthorized access. So this is the cyber security. That means here the term is very clear. Cyber security is technology or is a framework and the practices. The purpose for this technology or framework or practices is to protect the computer network. Network, that means more than one device is connected with each other and communicating with each other based on certain protocol. Devices, there may be a mobile device, there may be laptop, there may be a palm top device, there may be a sensor, programs, that means software system, and data, obviously the core part of the communication, data or information. To protect them with a attack, that means outsider or insider can launch attack which could data lost or the damage, again the physical damage or software damage, again it also could the loss of data, or as well as unauthorized access. Unauthorized access involves the data deletion, as well as unauthorized information access, that means stealing of the data or data theft. So to cope up all these threats, the design proposed is called the cyber security mechanism. And again, cyber security may also be referred as information technology security also. Now, again, cyber security and IT security both are similar. And the cyber security terminology, we can categorize or we can identify various subdomains of the cyber security, like the information security, web application security, network security, mobile device security, endpoint security, etc., etc. Now, cyberspace. So again, the main important thing, or for us to understand the term, what is the cyber? Or the cyber security, we can say the mechanism to protect the cyberspace. In other words, we can also say that the cyber security is nothing but a mechanism to protect all the activity or the infrastructure which is called the cyberspace. So the next thing is, what is the cyberspace? So cyberspace is nothing but it's a human made ecosystem. It comprises interconnected network, databases and source of information. That means cyberspace covers a very large spectrum. In other words, we can say the cyberspace covers the spectrum like network, hardware, software, and the mechanism or the policy through which entire system or entire IT infrastructure is handled. So this is the cyberspace. So for example, if you ask to maintain the security or to protect the banking system, in that case it is obviously you have to maintain or you have to protect the bank data. Again, you have to manage or you have to protect the bank website, you have to protect the banking network. Apart from that, to understand the human interaction with the banking system, that means the customer in which way interacting with the system, the employees in which way they are accessing the bank network as well as bank website as well as bank software, all these are important thing to protect, or all these are the essential component which also need to be addressed while you are discussing or while you are dealing with the banking cyber security. So this is the example. Means space is nothing only, or you cannot restrict the terminology cyberspace is only up to the network, hardware and software. You have to also think about the human or any other factors or any other mechanism through which the system is being operated. So we can say the cyberspace is not only including the software, hardware, data and information system, but the people surrounding it and social interaction within this network and infrastructure. Now, this is the body of USA, National Institute of Standard and Technology, NIST. So, according to the NIST, the cybersecurity is the ability to protect, defend the use of cyberspace from the cyberspace attacks. That means the cybersecurity is nothing but the ability, the skills, or the efforts, the successful efforts to protect or defend the use of cyberspace from the cyber attacks. So, If we look into the Indian cyberspace, so Indian cyberspace, that means government of India has formed several institution or several bodies to maintain the communication path or the communication mechanism within the country. Parallelly, government also has formed certain kind of bodies. These bodies are responsible to provide and to maintain or to set up and to maintain the communication for the public sector organizations and government bodies. So first one is the InfoNet. Between 1986 to 1988, three networks were set up. InfoNet, connecting the IBM mainframe installations that made up India's computer infrastructure. So InfoNet is the IBM mainframe installation which manage or through which India's computer infrastructure is made up. Then after NIC, that means National Informatics Center, NIC network. Now the most important IT setup of the government, by the government of India, the NIC provides the connectivity from center government to the district administration agencies. And the NIC is also developing software to serve the government requirements or government agencies requirements. NIC Net is a nationwide very small aperture terminal network for a public sector organization, as well as to connect the central government with the state government and district administration. So the entire communication hierarchy from the state to district and district to, sorry, from the state to district, and on other side from state to center. So this path is the district administration agency could also communicate directly with the center government. And apart from that, NIC, as we discussed, NIC has developed some prominent software for the government agency. Like we know in Gujarat, the popular product for the revenue department is E-Dhara, through which the land records are available to citizens. So this project is developed by the NIC. Then after education, research and research network. So this is the network to serve the academic and research community. So this provides the mechanism through which the research communities as well as academic communities can come close, and through which they can get the extended learning, benefit of extended learning, and we can say it is helpful to increase the research culture in academic communities. So this is the Indian cyberspace. Now next, government has established so many agencies, and these agencies are looking different aspects, or they are addressing the different issues of related with the cyber security. So the first one is the National Cyber Security Policy. National Cyber Security Policy is nothing but it's a guideline. It's a guideline for the individual as well as corporate, and it emphasizes on how to operate. How to operate the computers or how to use the cyberspace as a responsible citizen, and it also tried to protect the we can say the citizens or organization of country from the effect. So first one is the National Cyber Security Policy. It is not a particular agency, but it looks, it is a policy how to deal with the cyber security, how to maintain the cyber security in case of any breaches, how to identify or how to fix the responsibility of individual. So this is the National Cyber Security Policy. Then after National Cyber Security Coordination Center. So this is the center which coordinates with the government or with the parties, and it deal with the main responsibility to coordinate with the various stakeholder of the national cyber security. Then after, National Critical Information Infrastructure Protection Center. So government has also derived a national level grid, and through which the different government agencies can communicate with each other. So if we look, then they all, these are the interconnected network, and if government of one state would ask for certain kind of demand, then after the governor of next stage, or we can say the government of another state provides this information. Then after, Cyber Swachhta Kendra. So again, Cyber Swachhta Kendra is government initiative which protects individual against the threat. That means if you are having a laptop and if you want to perform the scan, then the you can get benefit of the Cyber Swachhta Kendra, because the government provides the security to end user also for the cyber attacks, from the cyber attacks or for the cyber security. Then after, Indian Computer Emergency Response Team, we can see RT. So this is the agency through which government of India can deal with other countries' police agencies, and they can exchange their interest for the country's development. So this is the Indian Computer Emergency Response Team. So it will deal with the emergency kind of situation. Then next, National Technical Research Organization, NTRE. Now this organization is to deal or to carry out the research or activities of the organization or research work of the ऑर्गेनाइजेशन. देन आफ्टर नेक्स्ट वन नेशनल इंटेलिजेंट ग्रिड. नाउ व्हाट हैपन, द गवर्नमेंट हैज फॉर्म अ ग्रिड और अ मैकेनिज्म, स्पेशल मैकेनिज्म थ्रू विच पर्सन और एम्प्लॉय फ्रॉम वन स्टेट टू अनदर स्टेट कैन एक्सेस एनी क्रिटिकल क्रिटिकल रिस्पॉन्स और इन द फॉर्म ऑफ रिस्पॉन्स. सो वी कैन से वी आर हैविंग द ग्रिड लाइक विच कनेक्ट विच इज विच कनेक्ट्स द स्टेट ऑफ कंट्री देन विच ऑल्सो प्रोवाइड्स द सर्टेन एस्पेक्ट और सर्टेन रिलीज मैकेनिज्म टू द कंट्री. एंड देन आफ्टर इंटेलिजेंट, सो वी डिस्कस द इंटेलिजेंट ग्रिड. देन इट मीन्स अ ग्रिड और अ कम्युनिकेशन कॉमन पाथ विच थ्रू विच गवर्नमेंट एजेंसीज कैन गेट द डेटा ऑफ अदर एजेंसीज. सो दीज आर द एजेंसीज. नाउ व्हाई इज साइबर सिक्योरिटी? सो साइबर सिक्योरिटी is having main three characteristics or any software or any system which we are developing needs to address these three point then after we can say our system is secured enough to deal with the security attack or cyber security attacks. So the first one is confidentiality, second one is the integrity, and third one is the availability. So it is very important for in terms of cyber security to maintain the confidentiality, to provide the integrity as well as availability for any system. Now first of all, what is the confidentiality? Confidentiality is nothing but the only right person or only legitimate person are able or can get access the particular event or occasion. So confidentiality, we can say in the confidentiality you need to address or you need to deal with the privacy. That means authorized person can only see the data, no one other can see the data. So this is the confidentiality. Then after second, integrity, that means as a developer you need to ensure the data in system or the we can say the multiple information of the same system should not be dealt, or we can say integrity, that means any authorized person can change the data, the unauthorized person are not able to change the data. This is the integrity. Then after availability, that means it is assumed or it is expected that the particular sun or particular grocery shop should be open at least minimum 8 o'clock. But now what happened in terms of availability? For example, the 24/7 is product is available, and on 8 o'clock it needs to be addressed certain issue, but somehow the service goes down. At that time what happened? They need to re-identify the resource, or they need to accept the challenge of the system and need to address, that means availability concern. Availability, that means 24/7 point basis availability. Then after cryptography. Now what is the cryptography? First of all, we need to understand क्रिप्टोग्राफी दैट मीन्स टू प्रोटेक्ट द डेटा, टू प्रोटेक्ट द डेटा द गवर्नमेंट सीड्स, गवर्नमेंट सेंड्स द डिक्री इनक्रिप्टेड मैसेज. And encrypted message, that means the entire by using some key or by using some values, the entire text has been encoded. That means that by using some key or some value, the text has been decoded into some another form, and in that form it is not readable until the decryption algorithm. So there are two types of encryption are there: symmetric encryption and asymmetric encryption. So the concept is like that for the encryption point of view: public key, private key. Now either in symmetric encryption or asymmetric encryption, the ciphertext is there. The ciphertext is, that means the mechanism through which the encryption algorithm mechanism or encryption idea. Then are the concept like public key, private key. That means the key must be, the data it sent must be encrypted through using the public key and private key. Now the next is hash function. Hash function is the mathematical mechanism to convert the original value into the encrypted value. And the so digital certificates are not part of cryptography. Digital certificates are a little bit different concept. Digital certificate, in other sense, we can say it's a kind of e-certificate which can be used to provide or to authorize the document. A person or an agency can have the digital certificate, and digital certificates are being issued by the certifying authority. Now, these kind of digital certificates are used to identify or to recognize the particular document, electronic or digital document. So, friend, this is the basic introduction of the cyber security. In this video, we discuss regarding the definition, or we tried to define the term cyber security. Then after, we also discuss about the cyberspace, and we discuss regarding the encryption and digital signature also, and we also discuss regarding the some prominent organization available in our country, set up by the government of India to facilitate or to increase the digital transaction, or we can say the cyberspace. Okay, friend, thank you very much. Thank you.
Swadhyaya.